The story of Miriam Ibrahim is headed for a happy ending. The Christian mother of two is out of Sudan and will soon head to the United States. But lawmakers and advocacy groups say the U.S. did very little to help Ibrahim and her family. In fact, they contend her case reveals the Obama administration's ambivalence towards religious freedom. Caitlin Burke reports.
Miriam Ibrahim is safe in Italy today. On Thursday, she and her family were allowed to leave the U.S. Embassy in Sudan, where they took refuge after her release from prison. Ibrahim's husband and children are American citizens, but it was the Italian government and the Vatican that negotiated her release, not the U.S. Tina Ramirez, founder of the religious freedom organization Hardwired, says that's unacceptable.
It is a matter of U.S. foreign policy under the International Religious Freedom Act of 1998 that we do care about religious freedom, whether it's for an American citizen or not an American citizen. But the fact that her husband is an American makes this case even more just unfortunate that the U.S. didn't get more involved from the beginning.
While Ibrahim was in prison, the Canadian government provided her with an air conditioning unit and some fans, and the British organized meetings with her legal team. But the U.S. didn't attend any of those. Ibrahim's case is only one example. Russell Moore, the president of the Ethics and Religious Liberty Commission for the Southern Baptist Convention, says this is not the time for the U.S. to be taking a lax stance on religious freedom.
The entire world seems to be aflame right now with persecution not only of Christians but of religious minorities in all sorts of places.
But Republican lawmakers say the State Department is more concerned with pushing the LGBT agenda than they are with defending religious freedom. Moore says Obama's indifference is further exemplified by his failure to appoint a new U.S. ambassador for international religious freedom, a position that's been vacant since October.
And that sends a signal to the rest of the world that the United States isn't really taking this issue seriously.
Caitlin Burke, CBN News.